Well, it's always, I mean, I say always, it's happened to me a couple times, so I can't say always, but you know, when you're sitting there and something that you thought of in your little office or at your little writing desk all those years ago is suddenly being filmed and made by hundreds of people with two huge stars, I mean, how could you not feel anything but lucky and happy is what I would say. It was amazing. Well, the noise is a phenomenon on this planet where Todd, Tom Holland's character, has landed. And the phenomenon is that everyone can see what everyone else is thinking all the time, whether you want to or not. So think about that for a second. I mean, that's all of your anger, all of your happiness, all of your songs you're singing in your head, but all of the lies you tell yourself, all the true things you think about your friends. It's pretty nightmarish. I would not want to live in it. I absolutely would not. It's kind of a reflection of social media, but taken to the extreme where you had no choice. So that was my starting point for the noise. And absolutely not. No way would I want to live in a world with noise. I mean, you never expect that. When you always hope. It's the Joy Luck Club quote that I use a lot, which is always hope, never expect. You know, you'd love it, but you never think it's going to happen. And so all those Knife of Never Letting Go fans from years ago who've been patient and patient about the film, that's really the special part, being able to share with them that here's the film finally, and here's Tom Holland, here's Daisy Ridley as your Todd and Viola, and they've been so kind and receptive and excited that I'm really happy they're going to get a chance to see it. It felt like it was all shot in a swamp in Montreal, but that was only a couple days, but it was in a swamp in Montreal. It was mostly Montreal and some in Atlanta. And the landscapes are so important to the book because the book has science fiction elements, but it also has very important Western elements. So the forests, the mountain lines, the vast fields of horses riding over them, that's really, really a key part of the feel of this place where it's like Earth, but it's not quite Earth. So yeah, kudos to rural Quebec, let's say. It was actually northern Quebec. It wasn't all Montreal, but it was mostly northern Quebec. And there was one very long day in a swamp. Well, again, it's that feeling of complete luck because it just all seems so improbable. You know, it seems so impossible until it happens. And my philosophy has always been whatever happens to the movie, the book always remains. And so, you know, the book isn't changing, the book's not going anywhere. And the book is mine. And the movie is a bunch of people's. And I just love being part of that with all of these other people who've worked so hard to you know, really make something good. And so if you've got that on your side, then it's going to be a good experience. Doug Liman is a very investigative director. He's always looking, always searching, always thinking. He's always throwing ideas. And that's an interesting creative process. You're always searching. And you're always trying to make it better. And so I would say that. He would always say, well, what about this? What about this? What about this? What about this? So it was always in discussion. Which isn't always the case, you know. Most often you get a screenplay that everybody's happy with and then you shoot it. Doug likes to go looking, man. He likes to look for a perfect shot. He likes to see what the day feels like. And, you know, that can be exhilarating. It can be bumpy, but he comes up with really terrific films at the end. So, and I think he's done it again.